With this workflow, you can create a daily to-do list and action sheet that reviews the past day's emails, the past day's events on your calendar, as well as give you a list of what you have coming up today. That way you can start every single day prepared with a report that gets emailed directly to your inbox every morning. All right, and let's see what actually happened with this workflow. So I'll come over to my email, and here we go. And it looks like I had it set to have it from my wife's account, but that's so be it. All right, so we get a morning report. It gives us a nice, beautiful little write-up here. Good morning, you glorious sunbeam of human potential. The universe just did a triple backflip of joy because you woke up today. How wonderful it is to wake up to something like that. That's right. Every atom in existence is currently high-fiving itself in celebration of your mere presence on this cosmic dance floor called Friday. And today is Friday as I'm recording this, so it knows what day of the week it is. Anyway, so what it's going to do is it's going to go ahead and give me my daily report on top of this awesome, uplifting, you know, explanation of how awesome I am as I wake up. I'm going to go ahead and check out the daily report. Here we go. It's got my emails. And so I have an input because I'm giving you a template. It doesn't have an input user at the moment, but it's got some review of emails for me here. It's got my calendar events from yesterday. And it's got, you know, what's coming up for today. So exactly what I said. Now, this is really cool because I have a single sheet that gets into my inbox every single morning that I'm now able to take a look at and go, hey, this is what I did yesterday. I'm able to check off, make sure I did it all. Here's all the email communications that I had to make sure that I covered everything. And here's what I got today. I got the time on it. I got the calendar event, calendar descriptions, and everything all from Google Calendar. All right, let's go into the workflow really quick, show you what it's going to do for you. So let's zoom in here. So we have this on a schedule trigger. I currently have it set to schedule every day at midnight 02, 12:02. It's first thing it does, it's got to figure out what is yesterday's date. In order to be able to pull yesterday's date from Gmail, from Google Calendar, it has to format the date right. So we have a quick little code note here that formats it. It's currently a year, month, day format for yesterday. It then runs it through Gmail and Google Calendar, and it does Google Calendar twice. Now for Gmail, what we're doing is we're getting all of yesterday's emails. And so that's just a quick setup, you know, you hook up your credentials. It's looking for everything from yesterday until today. And so it's gonna pull 30 top emails. You may need to increase that limit, you know, 40 emails, 50 emails, depending on how busy your inbox is. Either way, it's gonna pull those emails. It's then gonna run it through this code node here. This code node, really quick, I do need to explain it. It's gonna strip out a whole lot of extra stuff you don't need. So it's gonna strip out the HTML code that might come along with the emails. And we do this because a lot of emails, if we look over here, we have HTML of an email. And it just goes and goes and goes and goes and goes for ages. And no AI agent's gonna be able to accept all of that HTML code because there's just so much of it. Every color, every pixel, every image, all of it gets passed forward to the AI agent. There's no reason to be spending all those tokens. So we use this code node to strip all that out. We also strip out extra characters like extra quotation marks, backticks in case there might create an extra code block, as well as we're gonna remove a few what I call unwanted labels. Now you can adjust this to your heart's, you know, what your heart's content, whatever you want to remove. Let me show you how to do that really quick. So to be able to pull out emails that have specific labels. So over here we see I have an email that we're looking at. It's got these four labels here, and one of them comes with label number such and such. If I come back to my email really quick over here. Over here, I have my emails I have labels for my emails, and I have an email management or inbox manager that I'll link in the description below. I have a video on that as well. Anyway, what that one does is it labels all of my emails so that I can use this bot to be able to strip out emails that I don't want included in my daily report. In order to get those labels, you need to use this node up here. And all you do is you set up your credentials and you run it. And what it's going to do is it's going to come back with a list of all of your various labels. You just find the one that you want to remove. Say if I wanted to remove external, I'd grab that label code right there, bring it over to the code node, and just add it into the list here. So these are my code numbers for my labels. You want to remove those and replace them with your own. Either way, what it's going to do, it's going to strip out all the extraneous stuff we don't need the AI looking at. And then it's going to pass it to our AI agent. The AI agent, all it's doing is kind of giving us a breakdown summary of our emails for us. It's going to aggregate each of those together into one thing and then put it all together into one final email output that's going to then be sent forward into the report. We also have Google Calendar. We're going to get our events from yesterday and from today. So all you do is you set up your Google Calendar credentials. Here, this one's looking for today's events. So it's looking from before tomorrow and after the beginning of today. It's pulling all of our events. Again, you set the limit to whatever you want. If you have a super full calendar, you need to increase it. Otherwise, decrease it. And this one's pulling from before yesterday at midnight to today at midnight. All right. And so each of those is going to get passed through a quick code node that's going to just kind of restructure the information so that it's a little bit more presentable to us. That all gets aggregated together, merged together, aggregated together again so that we have both yesterday and today's events all in one. And then we run it through an AI agent, which is going to do a quick write-up of our events from yesterday, just kind of laying out what they were, and then structuring the ones from today so that we have the time it is, the event headline, the description, all the information that we need all ready for that report. All that information gets merged together, aggregated together, and then what we do is we create a new Google document. So we're going to create a new Google document. And what we do is we name that document of yesterday's date in the year, month, day format, daily report. It's going to get saved in the top level folder of our Google Drive. And that's just how end-to-end creates new Google Docs. It can only be in a top level folder. And so what we're going to do is we're going to move it to the correct folder using this Google Drive node. Just pick the one that you want it into. And then we're going to go ahead and put the information into the Google Doc here. We're grabbing the ID using our Google Doc credentials, inserting into the body. And here you can set this up to look a bit nicer. So like I said, it had this kind of default input username here. You'd want to put your name. If you want to have additional users, all you got to do is duplicate this whole process. So you just duplicate this whole thing for an additional user and then aggregate all of that together for the report, input it all. And it's just going to put it in one person at a time, all right? So you just put each person's emails, put each person's calendar. And then what we do is we run it through this node here. I call it your morning cheerleader. I have it hooked up to a DeepSeek chat node just because DeepSeek's a little less expensive. And what we're doing is just you're a morning messenger who's a beacon of positivity, energy. You're loud, you're theatrical. You're going to create this awesome introduction to them. It's going to be an HTML. And it's then going to say your daily report for yesterday's date is here. And then we go ahead and give it the Google Doc intro with our ID in order to be able to have a link to our sheet. And then it's going to go ahead and run it through one more AI agent. This AI agent is going to take that output, and I guess this one actually turns it into the HTML so that we can upload it to our Google, our Gmail using our credentials. In this case, I had the wrong credential, but you want to put in an email that it's going to send to, preferably yourself. The subject is yesterday's date, daily report. Email type is HTML, and our output is the output from that AI agent that created the HTML. And I guess I did that because DeepSeek's not so great at doing structured outputs or specific formats of outputs, and I wanted to use DeepSeek here. I guess you could get away with doing this with a single AI agent if you want and just make sure the instruction tells it to output its results only in HTML. Either way, that outputs it and it sends it directly to your inbox every single morning. And like I said, you can get today's workflow absolutely for free by joining my free school community down below. Just click the link, go ahead, and you can download that there. And if you want a more advanced version of this that's able to be processed in my larger Roger 3.0 system that includes daily notes that you're taking, that includes bug reports of your whole system, and is able to keep track of what tasks that you're acting on and cleaning up your spreadsheet, all while putting that into a daily report for you, you gotta join my advanced community. The link is down below. Go ahead and join that. We've got all kinds of cool things, including, like I said, my Roger 3.0 executive assistant that can do so much for you. Let me see if I can show you that really quick. We got here. It is able to do social media posts. It's able to keep track of your notes. It takes your RAG database, your weather, your calendar, your research, your deep research. It checks the news for you. It does so much. All in one tool, and you're able to get all of that by joining my advanced community down below. And if you found today's video helpful, please make sure to join our free school community, like and share the video, subscribe to the channel. It really does help get this information out there to everybody who needs it. And as always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.